Hello friends, I am Mrs. Geeta Zunjarwad, Assistant Professor of Communication Skills, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. We are discussing about the writing techniques of business letters. So in this session, we are going to discuss about writing techniques of effective emails. At the end of this session, student will be able to write an effective email. Email has long been a core tool for business communications. But in a 2013 survey, it is found that it has caused tension, confusion, or other negative consequences for 64% of working professionals. So it is very necessary to write emails effectively. So writing effective emails mean getting people to read and act on your messages. So how can you write emails that get the results you want? So in this video, we look at the strategies you can use to ensure that your email is clear, effective, and successful. So now let us discuss what is an email. Take a pause, think about the question, and try to write the answer. Now see the scientific definition of an email. An email is defined as the transmission of messages over communication network. So writing effective emails, the average office worker receives around 80 emails each day. With that volume of mail, individual messages can easily get overlooked. So it is very necessary to learn how to write an effective email. Follow these simple rules to get your emails noticed and acted upon. So the first rule is, don't over communicate by email. The second is, make good use of subject lines. The third rule is, keep messages clear and brief. The next one is, be polite. The fifth one is, check your tone. And the sixth rule is, proofread. So all these are the rules which makes your email effective. Now we will discuss all these rules in detail. So first rule, don't over communicate by email. One of the biggest sources of stress at work is the sheer volume of emails that people receive. So before you begin writing an email, ask yourself, is this really necessary? Because email is not as secure. So avoid sharing sensitive or personal information in an email. The next one is, make good use of subject lines. The subject line of your email message has two functions. The first one is, it grabs your attention. And the second one is, it summarizes the article. A blank subject line is more likely to be overlooked or rejected as spam. So always use a few well-chosen words to tell the recipient what the email is. See, this is the diagram of effective subject lines. A well-written subject line delivers the most important information without the recipient even having to open the email. These are the two examples. A well-written subject line like one below delivers the most important information. This serves as a prompt that reminds recipients about your meeting every time they glance at their inbox. So see these two examples. One example is bad example, which indicates only the subject as a meeting. And the good example is pass process meeting 10 a.m. August 25th, 2019. So in this good example, everything is described in detail. So this is a good example of a subject line. The next is keep messages clear and brief. Emails like traditional business letters need to be clear and concise. So keep your sentences short and to the point. Here I have given the examples. This is the bad example and this is the good example. So notice in the good example, Monica specified what she wanted Jackie to do. So if you make it easy for people to see what you want, there's a better chance that they will give you this. It's important to find balance here. You don't want to bombard someone with emails, and it makes sense to combine several related points into one email. When this happens, keep things simple with numbered paragraphs or bullet points and consider chunking information into small, well-organized units to make it easier to digest. The next point is be polite. People often think that emails can be less formal than traditional letters, but the messages you send are a reflection of your own professionalism, values, and attention to detail, so a certain level of formality is needed. So avoid informal language, slang, jargon, and inappropriate abbreviations. The next is check the tone. When we meet people face to face, we use the other person's body language, even vocal tone and facial expressions, to assess how they feel. Email robs us of this information, and this means that we can't tell when people have misunderstood our messages. So be careful about your choice of words, sentence length, punctuation, and capitalization. The last rule is proofreading. Finally, before you hit send, take a moment to review your email for spelling, grammar, and punctuation mistakes. Your email messages are as much a part of your professional image as the clothes you wear. So it looks bad to send out a message that contains typos. So proofreading is a very important factor before sending mail. Pay careful attention to the length of your email, because people are more likely to read short, concise emails than long, rambling ones. So make sure that your emails are as short as possible without excluding necessary information. This is the sample email message. So see this email. See the references I have used for making this PPT.